So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Beatboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel before you click onto any of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions in what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So WBO lightweight champion of the world Terry Turbo Flanagan could be having a big fight in the summer, either against his number one mandatory challenger Felix Verdejo, who has been his mandatory challenger for his WBO title for a while, but Verdejo was ruled out of boxing last year, and his career was put on hold because he was in a motorbike accident, and he was injured from that motorbike accident, so he had to really step aside from boxing for a little bit and recover. But he's made a comeback since Verdejo. I think he fought in February and won a unanimous decision, and Felix Verdejo, in my opinion, would be the toughest test of Terry Flanagan's career. Former 2012 Olympian, 23 wins, 15 knockouts. He's a very good boxer puncher. He's got quick hands and he's very good at putting shots together, and he has concussive power. Felix Verdejo, like, he can end a fight in one punch. I've seen it in many of his fights. Terry Flanagan as well hits hard. He's got a great engine. He's got pretty decent defense as well, Terry Flanagan, and I don't know, from distance Terry Flanagan is a decent fighter as well. He's very big for the weight as well, Terry Flanagan, so he could have a size advantage over Verdejo, and it'd be interesting to see how Terry Flanagan will get on with somebody like Verdejo, because in my opinion, beating somebody like a Felix Verdejo, even though you are the champion and he's the challenger, that would raise your profile and you'll be seen as a real star in the lightweight division, beating such a contender like Felix Verdejo. Because right now, Terry Flanagan's kind of boxed his way into obscurity, fighting guys like Petr Petrov and Orlando Cruz and Diego Magdaleno. Like, these guys are more fringe contenders than names in the lightweight division. Terry Flanagan has been mentioning that he's wanted big fights for a while. Another name being mentioned for Terry Flanagan, possible for the summer if it's not Verdejo, is Raymond Beltran, who people might remember, who fought Ricky Burns in Scotland a few years back, and basically, in my opinion, he beat Ricky Burns convincingly, and the fucking judges gave it a draw. So yeah, I think that would be a tough fight for Terry Flanagan as well, Raymond Beltran. So yeah, Terry Flanagan needs these big fights, because fighting guys like Petrov in his last fight, he didn't really look, I don't know, he just looked flat, Terry Flanagan. Like, he just couldn't really get up for a fight against a guy called Petr Petrov. And Petrov was number two with the WBO, but he was a fringe contender and he wasn't really a big name. And I think Terry Flanagan wants these big names now. I think he feels like he's been champion for a while. He's fought these fringe contender guys and now he wants to step up. But Frank Warren doesn't seem to be getting him these big fights. And he could have had a unification bout in the past when Anthony Quala was a WBA lightweight champion, but that fight never really got going either. He said he's been interested in fighting Vasyl Lomachenko, but he keeps fighting these fringe level opponents and it's not doing Terry Flanagan's career any justice at all. Like, Terry Flanagan did a ring walk in Manchester with Ricky Hatton holding the belt coming out, and the arena was silent. Like, the arena just didn't look buzzing at all. Like, Terry Flanagan, even though he's from Manchester, isn't a star in Manchester. He's not how an Anthony Quala is in Manchester. Maybe that's because Anthony Quala's career has been managed better than Terry Flanagan's, because Terry Flanagan is an undefeated fighter. Terry Flanagan has passed all the tests in his career so far, but he just hasn't had the right management from Frank Warren, in my opinion. But yeah, if he could get a big fight in the summer against Felix Verdejo, his mandatory challenger, and if he somehow managed to defeat Verdejo, because I'd be picking Felix Verdejo in that fight. I just think he's an all-round very good fighter for Felix Verdejo, and he could be a possible star. But if Terry Flanagan beat him, then that would definitely raise Terry Flanagan's profile, and then Terry Flanagan would be clamoring for the big fights against guys like Mikey Garcia and Jorge Linares. He needs a big fight, Terry Flanagan. So yeah, Terry Flanagan versus Felix Verdejo, possible for the summer. What do you guys think it is? Do you think there's a good fight for Terry Flanagan? Do you think a victory over Fideo will get Terry Flanagan on the map? And what do you think of Terry Flanagan's career so far? Do you think it's been boxed into obscurity? Just comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's Sweet Boxing.